We are in North Carolina shark tooth hunting for great whites, and we've checked 15 creeks in the past 3 days and haven't found anything, and we're finally on them. This man's first sift had a flawless lower great white shark tooth, posterior too. We're really excited to be here. We're gonna explore this creek more because it looks like it's got a lot of potential, and we're gonna find great white shark teeth.
Broken great white.
And a broken great white just like that?
Yes.
You gotta be kidding me. Colton found his 5 minutes ago, and I start sifting over here, and that is definitely a great white. That is so awesome. Look at that thing. Ooh, I'm so happy. That's what I came out here for. We've been scouting all day, all yesterday. Like, yes, let's get some more of these. Ooh, it's not bad.
No, just a little root damage, but...
That's still a pretty tooth. Great white shark. A couple million years old.
All right.
That's awesome. Get some more.
Yeah.
We dug a few more test holes here, but didn't find anything else besides those nice two great whites, and Maddie found two blades. So we're going to leave our equipment here, and we're going to hike further down and scout this creek both ways and see if we can't find some more locations. We're starting to see fragments of shell mixed in with the gravel, and that's a really good sign because this might be where the actual formation is exposed and where those fossil great white shark teeth eroded out of. So we're going to keep looking and see if we can't find that formation. Hey cutie, we didn't mean to scare you. We've seen lots of pretty turtles this trip. We're going to let you do you. See ya, buddy. There we go, that's the formation. We want more of that with some gravel. I just found what definitely looks like a human jaw, so... There it is. That is a human jaw. No doubt about it. All the teeth seem to be kind of gone, but... That's disgusting and also kind of cool. There's a cool old bottle, and then there's a jaw.
The question is the rest of him in here?
We are walking more, and that looks like a human skull. We haven't flipped it around yet. I don't know if we should or shouldn't, but...
Well, I feel like we should, because we don't want to call him out here. We don't know what it is. We should probably know what it is before we involve anybody else.
I don't think you should touch it.
Babe, it's not... It's
touch it.
We didn't,
we didn't do anything.
Don't, like, you're fine.
They're not going to be upset. We'll call law enforcement. We'll make sure that it actually is a skull, and then if that is... That's nuts. So we do want to be respectful here, because if this is a skull, no matter how cool it is to us, this was once a person, and if it is, they deserve to be either investigated for why they're here or properly buried. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn it over just to make sure, and we'll know in just a second. Yep, those are the eye sockets. That's a human skull. That's kind of crazy. I'm gonna put it back. And just right there.
Wow, that looks like it's been there for a long time.
I wonder how old it is. All right, well, we're gonna call local law enforcement and we'll hopefully get out here and be able to take it off of our hands, because that deserves to be dealt over by someone that knows what they're doing, not us. Hi, my name's Jonathan Valentine. I'm a small YouTuber who does educational videos and adventure videos in creeks looking for artifacts and fossils. I'm in a local creek in and we just found a human skull and human jaw. It looks pretty old, but we're basically 100% certain that's what it is.
Okay, where are you?
On the corner of and by. Yes, ma'am.
Alright, I'll get an officer over there.
You gotta duck a little bit right here.
It's 100 yards down from this spot.
Found some shark teeth though. In the creek, we found some shark teeth.
Yeah,
that's what we were looking for.
Quite a
Yeah.
Where at?
That's what we got.
Yeah.
Nothing crazy.
We have a lot of people that do come and search for stuff like this. And, you know, they kind of go everywhere.
Yeah.
We decided to do some exploring around, and we stopped in this creek today and went down that way, found a little bit, and we came up here and then found that, and it was kind of like, oh, we should probably contact somebody about that.
Give me 1 second. We're not going to tip this thing home.
Yeah, it's a little.
Yeah, I'm going to try the board.
You might have to submit at some point.
Yeah. I should have got my water boots.
Yeah, so the jaw's right here, and then the skull is right around the corner.
You see it from over here?
You're not going to be able to see it till you get right up next to it.
Right beside the glass jar, you see it.
It's right around this corner.
You got that there yet?
How far back is it, bud?
It's about it 10 feet past him.
Yep. I'm about to come back up so I can grab my boots.
Say what?
It's definitely a skull.
We've been wondering how old it might be. It doesn't have any teeth, so they can't use the teeth to match dental records. But it might have some DNA. The problem with that is it's in water, so all that DNA is probably degraded or dissolved. We don't even know how old it is, really.
So we look at the mandible. This is the first thing that we saw. It's very, very small. You can see normally with human mandibles that are more modern, we have a much thicker surface right here. Well, you can tell this smooth surface, that means that all the teeth have been gone. And since it is so smooth, we know that that happened before this person died. All of this right here was the bone repairing itself. So what we call this is antemortem tooth loss. So all of this up here, this damage that you see is all just post-mortem trauma. So that's wear and tear from after the person died skeletonized. Especially since we just found him in the creek, they've probably been tumbling for a while. So the skull's missing a lot of identifiable features. One of the first things we do to look at if we're trying to determine if something is historic or forensic significance is the teeth. You can tell there are no teeth here at all, but based on just how heavy the skull is, the amount of damage, and then also with this tooth loss, it does not appear to be forensically significant to us at all. Been asked, how old do we think it is? Honestly, there's really no way to tell.
How do we know that it's historical and not Native American or?
So one of the ways that we look to see if it's native or not is mostly the dentition. Also you have facial features that will indicate that. Again, the facial features are gone. There's no dentition. We do look at cranial shape. You can look at the eye orbits right here, kind of look at the nose. One thing about European populations or Caucasians, you tend to have a little bit more narrow of a nose. And just from what I can see, it looks like this nose is gonna be a little bit more narrow. But that's all I can tell about ancestry. So a lot of the time, if we can't tell ancestry, if we're not 100% sure if it's a Native American or not, a lot of the tribes aren't gonna wanna take possession of it. But it is a female. We can tell that based on the brow ridge. Men typically have more pronounced brow ridges right here. You can tell this is a little bit flatter. Also back here on this occipital protuberance, it's a muscle attachment area. So men are naturally larger here. You know, if you feel the back of your head, you can feel a little bump. Women, it's going to be small like that. Men, it's going to be much more pronounced.
Occipital protuberance.
Occipital protuberance.
Got it.
Yep. And the mastoid process is right here. These sit right behind your ear.
Yeah.
Same thing. Men, they're much larger, more robust. Females, they're a little bit thinner like this. So this is consistent with a female.
Well, thank you so much, Becky. That's awesome.
Thank you.
We really appreciate Becky and the local police officers that came out to help with this case. As always, if you guys enjoyed the video, please make sure to like, share, and subscribe. And we'll see you guys next time we dig some science. Take care.
get to drive.